But maybe you could just talk each of you for a minute about what specifically, because there's a lot of talk about middle class jobs on all fronts, frankly, and I can say that as a moderator, that there's a lot of talk about middle class jobs by everybody. What specifically would you do about it to you know, not just create jobs, but create what we'll call, you know, good jobs? I mean, the kind that we want our children to aspire to, which at the least would be ultimately a middle class type job to be inside a professional office country. So go ahead.
Well, let me just quickly say, if we are interested in preserving jobs as on the issue of pipelines, it would make much more sense to keep the jobs in Canada rather than to have them in the U.S. In general, I explained our position that, you know, corporate tax cuts, we're going to be doing that in the future, should be linked very directly to job creation. But I just want to also quickly say, because Chrystia has talked a great deal in this campaign about protecting middle-class jobs. And, you know, I think it should be pointed out that her own personal record on this is not very good. That as a senior executive at Thomson Reuters in New York, she oversaw the elimination of 25 good Toronto-based jobs and their export to India. You know, and I think that is a matter of some concern. And not only did she oversee that, she actually spoke in favor of that kind of outsourcing, or at least acknowledged, as she put it on a few business press statements, that this was good, so-called, as she put it, good business practices for business managers.
So you're next, and you can take the time.
Can I respond to Linda?
Yeah, go ahead.
So as Linda and John, both fellow recovering journalists, know, the shrinkage of newsrooms in North America began long before I became an editor and continued long after. The Toronto Star actually just last week announced 75 jobs were shrinking in their newsroom. Reuters, after I left, announced a 5% cut. Bloomberg, probably the richest news organization on the planet, announced that they're laying off 150 people. So I wish it were not the case, but it is a reality that North American newsrooms are shrinking, and I don't think there's anyone who would
lay off, not outsourcing.
Who was in an executive position while I was, who wasn't in an organization where that happened. Now, I will also say that being part of a company, and I'm very proud to have worked for Thomson Reuters, a great Canadian company, which has been a global success story, and we need more companies that are able to do that, was something which gave me some real insight into the pressures that companies face to be successful in a global economy. And it's part of the reason that I believe that you need government to get involved to find jobs for the middle class. But we're not going to solve this problem by pretending that businesses don't face these pressures and by pretending we can go back to the 1980s. That's not going to create any middle class jobs in Canada.
First of all, I think all promises made amongst these opposition candidates should be taken as a grain of salt until the parties tell you how Stephen Harper is to be removed from the Prime Minister's office. But on the question of